Wake up, make a joint, roll a coffee. Wake up, make a joint, roll a coffee. Wake up, make a joint, roll a coffee. Welcome to Struggle Street. This is Struggle Street.
Are you supposed to press record straight away?
Straight away.
Before I get in.
We're recording. Here it is, Struggle Street, episode 3. You Dizzy is helping his community by getting videos. He's on the scene.
He's on the scene. We just spoke to him. He's on the scene. He's on the scene. Video to follow. My hair looks great.
If he makes it in, he will. If he doesn't, not to worry.
Because we got Center Park Jones on standby.
Just in case.
But yeah.
So we're here. We're both up, just having coffee right now.
Yeah, this is literally this is how it should be done instantly.
Yeah, instantly.
Where we don't have an hour talking before and then say, "Oh, let's go and do it." It's got to be like, "Call me," and that's it. That's the call.
Yeah,
we did have a little 5 minutes before, and then I went and made my coffee. But it's getting closer. It's getting closer to the.
Yeah.
Getting closer to what I feel it should be.
Yeah. We're dialing it in.
Yeah. You know?
Yeah. We're dialing it in. That's all
we can do. Brian, your head looks fucking big and fuzzy today.
I have done nothing.
You just got to look. It's a massive head. Normally, my head's filling the screen.
I haven't done anything. I could switch my camera. Hold on.
You look fine. You haven't got to change anything. It's just an observation.
I'm using a different camera and microphone to see if we can.
Oh, there we go. See? Always improving.
Is it better one or two? It's like the eye doctor. Is it better one or two?
Is that one? Oh, I don't know. Which one? Is that two?
That's two.
Two's a little bit fucking. I mean, you should use two when you want to get your point across.
Okay, I'll keep it handy then. You know?
When it's something that you want to say, you should just fucking hit the number two button.
Hit the number two and get right in there. I can do that. It's handy right there.
Because that is effective.
Every day since we named this Struggle Street, I have been shown examples of why it's correctly named. Like, I must, in my life, I have probably put in Volkswagen Motors no less than, like, 50 is probably being conservative. It's probably a lot more than that, but I'll say 50. Like, if you've put in 50 air-cooled Volkswagen motors, you probably should be pretty good at it. Hazy Day sat with me yesterday. Was I on Struggle Street, brother?
You was. You needed help.
I did. It's in the car now. It's in. I mean, I didn't need help, but for whatever reason, it was definitely more difficult than it ever has been. So,
it would be difficult for anyone. You're sticking a fucking engine in a car on your own, on a jack.
I mean, the Volkswagen engine's not very difficult. You'll see when I do the next one. Oh, stay tuned to the VW Nut Channel. Something easy coming up. Super easy. You'll see with the next one, it just goes in and out because there's nothing around it. It's just in and out.
Yeah.
You'll see.
Why is there nothing around it?
Because that's just the style of Volkswagen that it is. I can't reveal it here. Later when we're talking, brother, I can give you all of the details.
Cool.
Stay tuned, though, people.
I was about to make a video on making bread pudding.
Bread pudding.
My channel, as you know, started off with music, but I do like to chuck other stuff on there. And bread pudding is, I don't know if you have it in America, do you? No, are you thinking of bread and butter pudding?
Listen, you're asking the wrong guy. You'll have to ask the people.
Hang on, I'm being cool. Hang on just a sec. Hello? No, thanks. Do I want my trousers washed?
Today or just in general?
In general.
While I'm wearing them? Can I keep them on whilst they're being washed?
Yeah, they're my work trousers. I like to wear work trousers, although I'm unemployed, you know, due to Struggle Street reasons.
Yep.
I do a lot of work around the house in my workshop.
I think calling yourself unemployed is a stretch, brother. I see what you do every day. I know what you do every day. I would say you are gainfully employed. Yeah, I would say you do is most certainly employment.
Yeah. Well, no, it's life, isn't it? It's, I mean, it's my job because it's what got to be done. It's what I was.
If somebody doesn't do it, if somebody's not doing what you're doing,
yeah, shit's going wrong.
It's not going to get done.
No, it's not going to get done.
It's not going to get done.
Sometimes I think a 9-to-5 would be like a fucking stroll in a park for me. You know, get up, go and do something that somebody's telling me how to do it, and I haven't got to think for myself, and I can just do it for fucking 8 hours or however long it is.
Instead of managing your own company, Smart Incorporated. Instead of managing Smart Incorporated.
Hazy Days Incorporated.
Hazy Days Incorporated.
Because we're not so smart.
Hazy Days and Family Incorporated.
Yeah. But I've got the right cup anyway, because I do like to think I'm the boss.
Yeah.
Boss of the situation.
But that's freaking Kate's cup.
That's the best thing you thought of.
Hollywood is free, bitches.
Listen, and I know he's in a call with us later in the future saying free rent. Free rent. As long as you're talking about me.
As long as you're talking about me, it's free rent.
Because he's Hollywood is free.
Hollywood is free, bitches. Hollywood is free. Listen, don't get it wrong. We love Dizzy. We are the biggest. Dizzy is our brother. We love him, but just as much as he would make fun of us, we make fun of him.
Yeah. I mean, you've been going out on him the last couple of days.
Yeah, he has it coming.
Yeah. I'm trying to back off him a little bit, you know?
He has it coming.
We do have some fucking serious banter, don't we? That's why I know you're good friends.
Yeah, he has. Dizzy has it coming.
when we can say the shit we say,
yeah,
to each other, and still stay in the same conversation, that means you're friends.
Yeah, and leave smiling.
Yeah,
right. Is that out of jar number one, or jar number two, or jar number three?
Well,
yes,
I think I can't remember.
Oh, that. Jar number one it is, then.
I think it's jar number one. There is actually jar number one. Yeah. It's the good stuff. It's the top shelf, you know? I got jar number three for just when I still got to do some shit.
Yeah.
Jar number two is for when I...
You say jar number two?
I do use jar number two occasionally. It's my in-betweener, you know?
I hit the Zoom when I said jar number two. See, it was awesome.
Oh, sorry. Yeah, you did. I'm sorry about that. That's what jar number one does to you. It makes you a little bit... makes you not realize about things that you actually said would be funny.
Right. Yeah.
You know what I mean?
I do know.
Yeah, so... I'm just chilling on jar number one.
I'm going to finish the plumbing in the 67 today. A little bit of brake adjustment work and finish checking the car out before I go test drive it. But everything should be okay. I mean, there's no reason not to believe that the car's not going to be okay. It's always been okay.
Yeah.
I just realized I've put 37,000 miles on that car since I've had it.
Holy shit.
Yeah. But that's what I have it for.
How long have you had it?
This is the fifth year. This will be the fifth season I've driven it. Yeah. As my daily.
That's quite a lot considering you only live in a little town.
Yeah. Like, I mean, how far do I really... I mean, occasionally we take it to Worcester, right? And...
Most of the miles are probably going to shows, is it?
Yeah, it's almost all of it. Well,
the long miles.
I mean, I use it for everything. I use it for the grocery store, for to take Sage to school, for...
Yeah.
I use it for everything.
What's your longest trip you've done in it, though? The furthest? Was it a Candy Mansion?
No, it's further. I've gone further than that. I've gone out to Western New Hampshire, which is 2.5 hours there and back. So 5 hours straight in the car.
Yeah. So 100 miles away-ish.
Yeah. I mean, I would drive across country right now. I would go from here to the other side of the country, Oregon or California. And that's, 7 or 8 days driving.
Any problems you think you'd have on the way?
You never can tell. I could have the other day in the 64, it runs perfect all the time, right? And then the other day I had to leave it at Barefoot's house, and I go there every day because it just didn't want to. They just break sometimes. So, I mean, you could have it perfectly tuned and perfectly maintained, and it could just be one thing. So,
my car's been going on fucking on a wing and a prayer.
I mean, but it's a $500 car, so.
Yeah, but some days it drives nice, and it's like, I think, oh, hang about, it's fucking sorting itself out. And then other days it's like, nah, we're going to chug a little bit today, you know?
Yeah.
But it's probably an easy fix, but I just don't want to start poking it, because other things break then, you know?
Yeah, it's like fixing something in your house, or if you restore old cars, or if you fix old houses or anything, it's opening the can of worms.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, if something's still working to the point where you can use it and it's okay, that I'll keep using it.
Break it till it's fixed.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's just like rolling a coffee.
Mm-hmm. Just like rolling a coffee. Right.
Yeah. Roll a coffee.
So new music for you. I know you're working on a new song, Hazy. I know you are.
It is. I am. But the thing is, I spend so much time, because I've got all my studio set up now, so I've got keyboard and everything, so it's all nice and comfortable, so I can just play shit. But I'm trying to build songs like a whole band. I'll play keyboard and then put drums and all sorts of stuff on. But when I start doing that, in my head, it starts getting messy. I'm trying to, like, overproduct it. Overproduce it, yeah. So then what I end up doing then is spending a week trying to record a song in a studio properly, and then I'll just pick up the acoustic guitar and think, fuck it, and I'll just play it how I wrote it, you know? And I think people seem to enjoy that more than when I do a more fuller production, you know?
Do you think you could conduct an orchestra? Like, could you be the dude standing at the podium with the...
No.
No.
I could stand there going like this. Do you know what? Like, if you know about that, you can see he's painting the picture. He's actually painting it. He got two paintbrushes, and every single move is a command. You know, he's like it's like a parade square, and he's the one. He's the what do you call it? The dude who runs a parade. I forgot his name.
The dude who runs the parade,
yeah, on the parade square in the army, you know, the one who shot.
I don't know. I wasn't in the army.
I know, but I thought.
No.
Didn't you do any marching?
Oh, we did a lot. We did all the parade deck marching, but that doesn't mean they gave us any information other than what we were supposed to do.
Who's the dude that's shouting at you?
I was the Marine Corps Infantry. I was the dude marching. I wasn't the dude worried about who the dude shouting was.
I'm trying to explain another point, going on to a point way...
Apologize.
The dude, he's doing this, and everyone's watching him, and that means you over there fucking blow a little bit harder, you know? If you go like that to Dizzy, he knows what you mean. Just means... blow a little bit out. It's a hose puller's code too. But yeah, no, on a serious note, yeah, I got some new music coming.
I know about blowing. Friggin' Hollywood is frigged, bitches.
Yeah, and on the production side of things, I I overdo it, because in my head, because it's virtual instruments, you know, so you start playing something and it just gets a bit crazy. But I'd rather just have a pick up a bass guitar, do some fucking boom, 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 you know, and just lay it down as I hear it, as it comes out of me. Because on my album, I think there's only three, I think there's three songs that I actually done like full band thing, which is Shake It On Round. That's like a full production. Bullet Holes. It's like a full production. That might be it. Might just be two, actually.
Maybe it's just two.
I think all the rest are just me and an acoustic guitar.
Just you, your soul.
Me, my soul, and six strings.
There you go.
Actually, I should plug it. Yeah, there if you go. Haven't bought this, you should go check it out. It's on all the platforms. Wherever you get your music from, you'll find this. If you type that in. You type Me, My Soul, and Six Strings. There's actually a link.
Yeah, go right down here. You can go to Apple Music, to any of them. All the links are right in the right there.
Yeah. So whatever's your favorite supplier,
whoever's
your dealer, whoever's your dealer, go and see them.
Yeah, go on over there and see them.
Can you believe it's been 2 years since I've done this?
I remember. 2 years. Right, you pressed them.
A week, 2 years in a week.
You pressed them right there in Small Album Nation.
Yeah, right here. I made these right here. I've done everything. I've done all the artwork. I've done everything. I made 100 of these CDs. There ain't none left. There's only two left, and they're for my boys.
I have one.
I made everything. Yeah. Brian has one.
I do. It's amazing. It's signed, even.
It is. Do you know what? That was the fucking weirdest part. People asking me to sign them. And I'm sat in my attic, Small Nation Army, with the fucking guillotine cutting bits of paper. I mean, I licked every envelope and every stamp. Everything okay there, Brian?
Yeah, I'm just getting to the comments from the last show so that we have them handy.
Oh.
That's all.
Who's Andy?
No, not Andy. Handy.
Did we have many comments? We had a few, didn't we?
Eight
comments.
Eight.
We're fucking Hollywood. Hollywood.
We are. It's moving right along.
And if you're still watching at this point, be sure to hit the like button.
Reach over there and subscribe. Like, it's only going to get better. Like, we try to make every episode better than the last episode. Yeah. And, like, it's Struggle Street, so we're going to succeed, and sometimes we're not. So
yeah, we're just going to chill. Well, this is just what we do. We just chill. We have a coffee.
Yeah.
In my massive cup.
In your massive cup. Yep.
Yeah, and we talk some shit.
And only
Dizzy's here. But Dizzy's at the moment pulling some hoses.
On the scene with the Hose Puller Brigade.
On the scene.
On the scene. Doing the best thing he can for his community, which is amazing. What he does for those firefighters to help them guys is amazing.
And he just spoke to a dude, a random dude, who knew who I was.
I don't think he was random. I think him and Dizzy probably.
He just pulled the passerby.
He was on a fire scene. The dude looked like he was a firefighter. I don't think the dude was random.
He did have some sort of fire engine sticker.
Yeah.
But he knew who I was. Go on, read some comments, Brian.
Okay. The first one is from our good friend Barefoot. You know, we all love Barefoot. He says, thank you for the respect, brothers. You know, in the last video, we gave him all the respect. You know, our friend, Sean, Iron Man, he said, my honey is from the Fakawi tribe. She stands there with her hand showing her eyes, trying to figure out where the Fakawi.
Where the Fakawi?
Tom's First Generation Garage gave us a big thumbs up. Shorty's channel.
What's up, Shorty? I haven't seen you for ages. I hope you're well. And you, my camera's down there. I just realized that I'm looking at. That's something I got to figure out. So I don't feel like I'm making eye contact with people. Like, no, I am. But I can't see you because you're up there. Like, that's eye contact.
That's eye contact.
Hello, everybody.
That's eye contact. Hello, everybody.
You're all doing well.
And our co-host who can't be here with the big arms in the thumbnail, he said first. Of course he was first. He was there through the process. And that concludes the comments.
Yeah, he was the first because he wanted to watch it. He was the first to watch it.
Yeah, he was the first one to watch it, the whole thing. Yeah.
I don't know if anyone have noticed the thumbnail from the last episode, from episode one, but it was quite funny when I made it.
Our friend Dave is really that big. He really is.
When he puts one of those wife beater vests on, it just slims him down.
Yeah.
You know, as soon as he takes that off, fucking he's Popeye again. His arms are like that.
Yeah.
He pops.
Mm-hmm.
You know? He works out a lot.
Yeah. He does a lot of hand-to-mouth exercises, near-mouth exercise. He does work out a lot.
Well, is Brian on the other hand? Don't work out so much, do you, Brian?
No. We definitely have had to slow her down a little bit. So we just slow her down a little bit.
I don't work out as much as I was. I mean, I bought a bike and everything. And now I'm making a bike shed to hide it.
A bike shed. Well, see, it wasn't really bike season. Now it's kind of coming around to bike season.
Oh, yeah, bike season's coming. Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
Yeah, when did I buy it? Just for Christmas, when it's raining and all bad shit.
Yeah,
and I've got a seat on the back for Harry, you know.
And the world was locked down, right? Like it's hard, you know.
Well, that was the whole reason I bought it, to be honest, because I felt like because you couldn't go driving anywhere, if you got a bicycle, you can go anywhere you want. You know,
it's when you're locked down, even if you don't, like me, you don't want to go anywhere. Like being told you can't go anywhere is different than not wanting to go anywhere, right?
So, and to be honest, I had major issues with it in the beginning, like major issues. It brought back loads of negative shit that I bottled away.
Yeah, you're not alone. You're not like, I'm sure you're not alone. I'm sure there's people out there listening to this right now that had the same problem. I can only imagine there are.
It took a while for me to figure out what was happening. But like when I was a kid, like I was grounded a lot and shit, you know, and always fucking not allowed to go out. You know what I mean?
Yep.
And it just brought back shit that I locked away.
Yeah.
And it fucked me up. In fact, just saying it, just talking about it now, I can feel like I don't want to talk about it. You know what I mean?
Yep.
Because I figured it out. I figured out why I was... went a little bit fucking pear-shaped, and then it brought back loads of bad shit. And when you open up a fucking bag and see the bad shit on the top, you end up having a little rummage through and finding other bad shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah, you don't want to go digging around the sides either too far, right?
Yeah, which is what I've done. I done it. I started digging in, and I was like, whoa, let's fucking leave that bag alone. Let's fucking stop everything. That's why I stopped drinking and everything, because it was all coming to a head. Like in a bad, bad way, you know. So I just had to. I stopped everything. I stopped smoking, drinking, eating bad food. Just so I knew that I was still in control, 100%. I think that's how I deal with it.
Yeah,
you know.
You have to remind yourself.
Yeah, I get to a point, and then I'm like, right, now you got to take control again, otherwise you're fucked. You know, it's the end. If you can regain control, it's not a fucking not a good scenario in my mind. You know,
for me, I think just across the board, I think that's solid advice. I think being able to recognize that you need to maintain that control, I think that should be good for everybody. Should be able to recognize that they need to maintain that control, right? Yeah.
Because the hardest thing about having shit like that is figuring it out yourself and understanding why in certain circumstances you feel certain ways.
Yeah, sure. Because
you've got core beliefs within you that you don't even know nothing about. Yep. Things that were instilled in you from a young age, like core beliefs, that they're in you. Although you've got nothing, you had nothing to do with it being built.
Yeah.
People around you built that core belief.
Yep.
You know, it controls your life forever.
Forever.
And some people don't recognize it. They just go through life and not giving a fuck about any bad programming that was put in them. You know what I mean? And it's tough. It's a tough world, man. It's a tough world. But this is what struggle is about. This is why. I mean, we've touched on this naturally. We've just progressed to this.
Yeah, we just came here.
But this is the reason.
Really, that's the real struggle. Brian
at least want to do Struggle Street.
Yeah, so, I mean,
like, you know, if we can take your mind off anything bad, negative for fucking 30 minutes.
Yeah. You know,
although now I'm probably provoking fucking thoughts and whatever. If you're listening to my shit, if we can take your mind off it for 30 minutes and make you smile for a second.
Yeah.
We've had a good day, you
know? And feel free to reach out to us either in email or like both of our emails for our individual channels are there. If you're having problems with these issues, and I'm sure that both of us would be happy to point you in places of help. By no means are we either one of us probably would admit that we're not the people to help people, but we could probably help you find people to help you if you're having problems. And for sure, we'd be happy to do that.
Yeah, and a lot of times that's the problem. Most people, although they might understand that they need help, reaching out is the toughest. It's the hardest.
Yeah.
Because it's all on you, and you're the one that's got to explain everything. Mm-hmm. You know.
Yeah.
It's so much easier to just fucking sit there and say, do you know what? I'll just keep it to myself.
I'll just stuff it.
Because it's easier than
I'll
having
just
to
it.
Fucking explain it. But you know, explaining it is part of getting yourself sorted out, you know, because there is hope for fucking everybody, no matter how dark your fucking your bag of fucking nasties is. There's hope. You know what I mean?
Yes. Yesterday's gone. It's gone. Yesterday, that's gone. Today.
Yeah.
Today, that's happening right now. That's happening
right now.
Tomorrow
haven't happened yet. So
tomorrow, that's not guaranteed. It's not.
Did I just do a fucking, what the fuck was that? I didn't mean to do the fucking woohoo. I don't know what that was. I've never done that in my life, but fuck it. Yeah, just try and be happy.
Yeah.
You know, roll yourself a coffee.
Whether it's 1 5 minutes at a time, 1 minute at a time, 1 5 seconds at a time, whatever it is, whatever you need.
Yeah. Yeah, but like Brian said, if you need to reach out and speak to somebody, you know, I'm not saying I can sit there and answer fucking, because I struggle answering comments, you know, because I'm dyslexic and shit. So most people get everyone gets a heart and a thumbs up. If you comment, regardless if it's fucking negative comment, you still get a heart and a thumbs up. And if you're a fucking ass, then you get deleted. But
if you're an ass, if you're an ass, you get my address.
Yeah. Yeah, you come and figure it out.
We'll come sort it out in an individual assortment.
Yeah, but listen, I'm up for fucking video calls. If somebody just wants to have a chat, I mean, I can't, you know, sometimes hang about, I should slow down.
Yeah, you should slow your roll. That's why I said we could point you in the direction.
Because I do want to help as many people as I want, but if I got fucking even 50 people calling me, it's going to be a little bit too much.
Yeah, we'll be able to point you in the right direction. We can help you go in the right direction. Get you.
We can figure something out.
Email me. I can definitely get you going in the right direction. Especially for me, especially if you're a veteran looking for help. Most certainly, I will find you help.
Another thing I was thinking about as well, just to fucking have a bit of interaction with the people that are watching and figure out how far we're actually broadcasting in the world. If you're watching and you're not in America or from the UK, I'd be interested to know where you're watching from. So you can just leave a little comment telling us where you're from.
Yeah, let us know.
And I've actually got a world map up above me, just I'm not going to start moving my shit. But I've got a world map just above me. And I might even start sticking pins on it and seeing who's where and shit, you know? But yeah. Yeah, we've done 30 minutes, Brian.
Yeah, we did. We did good.
Yeah. Well done. This is the end of the show, folks.
Friggin' right. Links for...
Dizzy was quiet. Dizzy was quiet this show.
Yeah, he was. But link for everybody in no particular order in the prescription below. Yeah.
No particular order, but it's just coincidence I'm at the top.
Well, you have the most shit going on, so...
Yeah. Peace out, people. And hope that the second half wasn't too boring. Oh, look at this shit. Dizzy's calling us.
I just hung up on him. All right, I'm going to end this one. That one. Wake up, make a joint, roll a coffee. Wake up, make a joint, roll a coffee. Wake up, make a joint, roll a coffee. Welcome to Struggle Street. This is Struggle Street.